I think we should explore this kind of throwing off there.
Does team chemistry come before winning, or does winning come before team chemistry? It's the chicken and the egg.
I think it's about how important to have better players.
I want to go back and explore the guy at the bar with the game.
Yeah.
Saturday. Obviously, Justin was limited last Saturday. He really hasn't practiced the last few days. Is there an expectation that he could scrimmage or he could do at least something on Saturday?
Have you been drinking? Saturday.
Not yet. New York accent.
Okay. He had some medical tests done yesterday that we did not have the results completely back yet. And if they're clear, then he'll practice Saturday. He just had some health issues.
How'd Trent Wessel look today?
Good. That's your guy. Only four-string quarterback. He has a six-page article right at the bottom.
Longest article ever on LIS.
No, we actually gave him some reps for the twos today. He's been doing really well. Worried about what he can control. You know, he doesn't get much reps as some of the other guys, but you know, finds a way to make plays when he goes in there. Did it today in the 4 minute. Actually would have won the game for the twos there by rolling to his left, making a completion to make the final first down in the game. So, does a good job.
How's the offensive line coming together? I know, you know, Doug Johnson's now competing at that right tackle spot. How is that group coming together?
I think they've done well. As kind of always has been, we've struggled with numbers. For whatever reason, offensive line and receivers, we end up with transfers, and we just struggled to keep guys, so our depth's a concern there. But I think the first unit's playing well. Brandon's playing really great. Left side's a little further along than the right side, so we'll keep going.
Do you treat the Calvin Ashley stuff like it's just an injury that happens in camp, or is it easier because he was never out there? How do you kind of address that with the team? How do you approach that as a coaching staff?
I didn't address it with the team. I mean, he never practiced, worked out a little bit on and off. I didn't really feel I need to address it. You know, like I said, disappointed because, you know, I put a lot of energy into, you know, getting here and working with him while he was here, but I guess that's nowadays. You know, you just gotta like play on these kids. I just talked to an old coach today that was out there, and he just said, boy, it must be different nowadays. Like, can you even coach him hard? I'm not saying that about Calvin, I'm just saying in general. He said, can you even coach him hard? Because it just seems like as soon as kids that are, it's not going their way, they're out of here. You know, be like being in the NFL and you can, you know, contracts, you can just get on the contract whenever you want. Be a pretty interesting league.
And has Doug made a big step since spring, or?
Yeah, he has. Really done a good job, changed his body. I thought he was a really good recruit when we signed him with a lot of potential, you know. Had to get in shape, and he's done a good job.
A guy like Brandon Robinson, you see him making plays. With his length as a wide receiver, is he a guy who you can see in the rotation? And what does he have to do to get more reps?
Yeah, I mean, he's right there now. You know, they're outside receivers, not a lot of depth there. Probably a position of a lot of work and concern. The amount of transfers, and for whatever reason, we kind of ended up with a lot of smaller guys, more of the bigger guys. So hopefully, he continues to make plays.
I mean, he's been around for a couple of years. I think your first year here, he had a pretty big spring game with, you know, toward the end. Is he a guy that's just kind of stuck with it and hopefully get an opportunity?
Yeah, he has. I think he was even the MVP of that game, if I remember. So, you know. See these guys all the time, forever. You know, a lot of times when you stay, you play. You know, especially nowadays in sport, everybody leaving. You know, a lot of times these guys that maybe are buried when they're young, you know, on depth charts, they stay and they hang around. James Charles, great example. You know, James Charles, arguably is our starting running back right now. So, stay, you play. It's a good lesson.
And with the running backs, mainly James and Emmons, is that a workload was. Last year, you used Carrick and Motor kind of evenly, you know, about 20 a game around there. Is that, could you see yourself doing the same with Charles and them as at least to start the year?
Yeah, we could, but I don't know. You know, with really nobody that's played a lot, you know, I don't think any of us know what's going to happen once we start playing games. And you know, and then you got some really, really talented young guys that, you know, have special abilities that, again, you got no idea what's going to happen. You know, you got a guy like Malcolm that's, you know, arguably as talented as all of them, you know, when he puts things together. So it's a good problem to have. It's our deepest position. And I think it's pretty, I would be safe to say, our most talented position.
The format for the spring game, or the, I'm sorry, the scrimmage on Saturday, is it any different than last week?
I haven't figured that out yet, but I would anticipate tackling early and seeing how long. And you know, like last time, we went and tacked in all the way until the 2 minute drill. So we'll see.
Thank you.